So you're wondering, whenever you go on a vacation and you have a Tesla Model 3 EV and you don't want your battery to be depleted by the time you get back to your vehicle that you left at the airport. Well, that's what this video is about. We're gonna talk about it. So basically, I'm gonna do this video. I am YouTubeKeN. If you don't know, welcome to my channel. I wanted to go over some of the settings in the first half of this video that I will show you that should achieve that goal of not having 0% or close to 0% of battery life in your Tesla Model 3. I will be parking under a covered parking near the airport and paying to store my vehicle there. And they also have EV charging as well. Never done this before. I don't know how that's gonna work, but changing these settings will guarantee I will have some battery when I get back to my car and go to a supercharger. Let's go to the car. All right, I made it in the car and I wanted to go over a few settings that I think will help someone who is about to travel like myself for a few days. First thing we're gonna go to is safety and security. And I'm gonna scroll down a little bit. And you see, of course, like probably everybody, every other Tesla owner, we have sentry mode here turned on. That will definitely drain the battery, especially if there's an active parking lot where I'm located, cars coming in and out, people arriving and leaving. So we're gonna turn that off. So that should help a lot with the battery. The next one is cabin overheat protection. And what this is, it maintains the cabin temperature under 105 degrees Fahrenheit if your car is like parked up to 12 hours. I'll be gone about 3.5 days. So I think it's good to have that turned off. This feature does not operate when the battery reaches 20% or less. They're gonna be charging my car, so I don't have to worry about it. This video is just to help someone who will park in an open parking lot. No chargers, no one supervising your vehicle. You're trying to save as much battery as possible. So we're gonna turn that off. The next option under the same safety and security is data sharing. This is an option for you. Our Tesla send data to Tesla random times that could drain some of your battery. So what I would suggest is if you want, you can turn them all off and then turn them back on when you get back. I'm gonna leave them on. Like I said, my situation is totally different from someone else's situation. Next option is going to be under display. And I'm gonna scroll down a little bit. I will show you a screen recording. Whenever you remote into your car via the app, it will show you, depending on what you have here, energy display or distance set. So up here it says 90% because I have it on energy. If I switch it to distance, it'll show 315 or how many miles you have. So that means whenever you leave your car, whichever way you have it set, it's going to basically show that on your smartphone. So I think that's something, and depending on your preference, if you check your app, which I recommend you don't, because that will wake your car up and drain your battery even quicker. But if you're hard-headed or whatever, you can definitely switch whichever one is best for you. As you see, it keeps changing it. All right, so that's all under display that I'm going to change. And the very last one is autopilot. Sounds kind of crazy. There is one feature that could drain your battery while you're gone. Under here, under the summon area, you're gonna hit standby. And what that's gonna do, I always have my standby mode on because if I summon my car to me in a parking lot or summon it forward or in reverse, the car is always on standby where it can work a whole lot faster. So I'm gonna turn that off. So the car will not be looking and always on standby when I'm trying to summon the car. So that's pretty much it. So this should save me a little bit of battery. I might put a little bit more footage showing what my battery percentage is, and also when I arrive back. So I made it back home. Just wanted to go over some things that happened. So when I did drop the car off at the shuttle place where you can park your car and pay for it, and like I told you, I wanted to charge my car while I'm gone. Well, that really didn't happen. It didn't take the charge. So it was something wrong with their outlet, I guess. I guess this is a good thing, because if someone doesn't have the means to charge their car, this video is to kind of give you a sense of how it drains the battery. So I came out of the airport and I got into the shuttle. The shuttle service is very fast. It was right there. I think they are supposed to be there every 5 minutes to pick you up. So once I did get there, I checked my car out. And as you'll see in the video, I did try to plug the outlet that Tesla provides into another outlet and see if it would charge. It would start charging and it'll show like 8 hours and somewhat minutes and it would just stop charging. And there, I checked the error message and it's something, I can't remember what it says. You should see that on the screen. But after that, I did go to a supercharger. I don't like driving my car very low on battery charge. And what I did was everything worked perfectly. Also, one thing, if you can see something in the video that seemed a little odd to you that's not working, let me know in the comments below, because I had to set up a service appointment so I can get that fixed. Not really a big deal. When I was on the interstate, the only difference is the Navigate on autopilot. It works just like autopilot, but I want to get it fixed. I just don't want to tell you. I just want to see if you recognize something when I was pulling into the supercharger. So when I arrived early Friday morning at the airport and I parked my car, my battery was at 77%. I charged it up to 100% because it's about an hour drive. Keep in mind, I was going to check my app, all of that stuff, because the car was going to be charging the whole time, 3.5 days that I was gone. So as I said, 77% is when I dropped the car off. By Saturday, 5:31 a.m., it was at 69%. So basically, it drained 8%, basically in 24 hours, because I dropped the car off around 5 a.m. that morning, and by Saturday at 5 a.m., it had dropped 8%. To me, that's a lot. So that's when I went to the stats app, put the vehicle in a safe location, and then did not look at the app at all. So from Saturday at 5 a.m. until Monday, that evening around 6:30, it only dropped to 67%. I don't know if you see a big difference in that, but that is, to me, a very huge difference. With me having Sentry mode on and checking the app, it dropped 8% in 24 hours or less. But once I turned it on, then it went from 69% only to 67% in the matter of, I would say, 2 days. So that's the difference, and that's why I wanted to make this video. But definitely pay attention to your settings if you don't have the means to charge. Hopefully you all enjoyed this video. Please leave a comment and let me know if you spotted what the issue was that I just set a Tesla service appointment for. And this will be my first Tesla service appointment. Like this video, subscribe to my channel if you see fit. This is YouTube Ken. I'll see you in the next video.